Hello, everybody.
Larry, we are about an hour's drive southwest of downtown Boston in the area known as Patriot Place, Gillette Stadium, here in Foxborough. Straight ahead, it's a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl. And it'll be a great one between the Kansas City Chiefs and the New England Patriots.
Excuses for guys being out. Senior guys are okay.
that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
And Butker able to put this one through. And that will make it 10-0 here in the first. So the defense gets the pick. The offense, Charles, they go backwards, but they do get 3 points.
Very happy to get the three, but you know what's happier? The defensive team on the other side, they shut them down after the turnover.
He spins free. They work their way back out onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, a little bit more cautious when you start that. He's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Oh, free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble, because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he better get on to make the play. A big play to deserve for the offense.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern, because once you start in a certain pattern, you wonder, can you get out of it? And that affects the other way, too, and you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth.
Leopard,
set. They're going to try and throw. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. Real head scratcher there. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. Now, Carter, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now?
The coach is trembling. There's no doubt about it. People wonder what that decision was. But it takes me back to a number of years ago. A very successful coach in the league had told himself before a playoff game he was going to be aggressive. No matter what, he's going to be aggressive. And it ran his team into some real problems early, and they got upset in that playoff game. Let's see if this team can recover.
Aggressive in capital letters with glitter, 7 underscore. I mean, that's the definition of aggressive.
Yeah, you can almost hear the cheerleaders doing the be aggressive chant behind him, and he listened to it. Everyone's going to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, if you're on offense, be aware.
Pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. The Kansas City first, Smith finding his fellow Pro Bowler, Kelsey. A pretty sizable deficit here in the first quarter. This defense will probably need to get off the field in those situations on third down.
You and I both know this kind of third down. This is what we're going to talk about. Let's make a play. Let's get off the field. Let's reverse the momentum. Instead, they get hit with another first down. Almost back to the drawing board.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Back.
Yeah, he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did run a quick takeoff as the ball was snapped. But I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too. They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I said keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Good play action, hit him over the top.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Travis Kelsey, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs add on to their lead.
Well, the lost sleep that the defensive coordinator had all week preparing for this game, a good portion of it was trying to prepare for him, because he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a lot of times around the goal line, they know what's going to him. It's just so hard to stop.
And that's what really becomes difficult.
It's been an awfully slow start for them. This is their third possession. They don't have a first down yet.
So that means they have to change up what they're doing. And for some teams, it's a change in tempo. Usually moving it to more up-tempo type of an offense just to try and change their fortunes right now. What they've been doing so far isn't working. Maybe they'll do that.
When you're down early, how do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
And I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game. He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let him outside. They can really shred your defense.
This is White on the screen. And we'll get to the 29-yard line brought down there. Well contained there defensively. The screen gets only a yard, and it's fourth.
He dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Now, remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. They'll try and throw for it here. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, Elijah says they're near that to a first down. 14 yards is the pickup there in the New England first down.
They accepted the risk, and it was rewarded. What a catch on fourth down. To create a first down situation for one more time. A catch.
It was close, perilously close to a turnover on downs, but picked up the first.
How about getting his feet down, though? That's footwork.
4 yards remaining now on second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll look to throw. It's caught left side by Crooks.
Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now. The field goal probably feels like this.
Broken tackle, but not much room there ultimately. Just up past the 25 and no further. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down.
Well played, I must say. Only getting 1 yard. There's no room to run. Space to maneuver at the 40. Some open field here. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Spencer Ware, 74 yards. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play as an athlete going a long way. Butker now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. To see what they can do this time.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
Hey, watch the slant. Watch the slant.
Leopard. Leopard.
They go play action here on first down. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. Chris Jones.
Back there.
In there. Make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that common yardage. Not a great start.
Over the middle, it's Amendola. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back at the 11-yard line.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a pass for about how far you let your guy go, because he might want to be just
looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted.
Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. They'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 7.
Back-to-back runs. I'd say that encompassed a maximum effort.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. Just outside of the 10 at the 11. Now whistles blow and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. And the kick by Butker is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for 6, but they do get 3.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
So out now comes the offense back on the field. Right now, they're in some uncharted waters, Charles. They haven't been facing deficits like this season. We're going to see what they're made of.
And I think the easy thing right now is for us to discuss how the home crowd can help them, carry them along. Bottom line, though, they've got to make plays to get the crowd back into it, to help them with the rest of their game. That means best players got to make those big-time plays. Right now, they need them in a big way.
They fought so hard to be here at home for the conference championship game. See if they can propel themselves to the Super Bowl. Is fielded at the goal line. Spins past him. And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. They also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Chiefs, 55 yards on the ground. Smith with a give to Hunt. Stopped that for only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Try the air, that was Smith. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. That's all good for only a couple of inches on third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety now. It's built like this guy. He's a big target, a guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when you're on the target top.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get down to 7. Again, it's 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses, it's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
Not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though this offense is struggling, they're putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points.
Set to take over again. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
You know, the key to a good screen pass is, Don.
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. The coach is still active. You want to let the defenders go past you. Whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all.
Jack,
they
Patriot,
actually ran
Patriot.
With the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yards. Trying to hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the hole. Now back to throw. And it is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And one possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. Well, it's gutsy to go for it in the red zone. The problem there is they're in the why in the world did they do that?
They must have thought they had the exact play call that they needed to go to. And I'm still not even having that. I'm reaching.
You're searching.
Not sure I'm reaching. But I do know this. On the other side of the field, that coaching staff is screaming at their defense. If you don't handle this one right here, this is a great opportunity for us. Take it away, guys. And they did.
And now excellent field position. 1 second down. Here's Smith.
In Indianapolis, I think we're seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well, they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
He spins away, and he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, cost a turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he's going to find Hogan here, complete. Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
Here we go now. Blue landing. Blue landing.
Back to throw now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. I understand why they look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Back to throw. throw that on second and 10. Fires one incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. And it'll bring up third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because at incompletions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another
all
shot
right,
here
lock
in the
56.
First half.
Lock it, 56.
If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Incomplete. Normally I'd say this will lead to a punt attempt, but this offense already shown in the first half that they'll go for it on fourth down.
Well, they should have already said punt it. Punt it. Head coach have already made that decision.
Hurry up, here we go.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. This is caught. It's caught in by Gronkowski. And he's going to be marked down deep into Kansas City territory. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal. They'll set up a throw.
Keep chopping down this lead in the second.
They still need to regroup and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. And he will get into the end zone to cut the lead a little bit further. They get the conversion. And Drew, you only have 2 yards to go. What do you think of the toss play? Because initially it kind of sets you back a little bit.
It does, especially if you get a lot of pressure coming towards you. But if you can get to the edge, if you seal the edge with your blocking, often your tackle or your tight end on what they call the play side where the ball goes, you can get to the corner and allow those big guys to get out of the end of the run.
Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Set to return, this is Brandon Cooks. Oh, 360. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out on the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
Never probably make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more shit than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game.
Here we go.
I'm sure they're scripted to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone into this game.
Let's see if that script is good. And they get it down the number 4, takes it across the 40-yard line. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
Some pressure was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much right after the catch.
First down, they drop the throw. He gets it out of the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A gain of 6 there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage in your tight end.
Catching it left side. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what they're doing that one is the receivers get the ball delivered in good timing and they get it done.
Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. And it's second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit.
He's
wide
open
right there.
And those are the throws that haven't been available to him every time he's dropped the pass. That's a big miss. Touchdown of the game. And the Patriots
and you know that there was an emphasis on their side. We know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much. It's trying too hard. You don't get the score. A proper combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And that almost makes it a brand new ballgame. Now it's a one-score affair after they get the two.
And you have to know they were holding their breath on the two-point play because they had to have it to get it within the range that you just talked about. Down with their two-point play. It worked. Now they're feeling like they've got a shot at this one.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. The third quarter has not been kind to them. After they built that lead at intermission, they've seen that lead shrink.
And how much of that is simply execution? How much of that is maybe you lose your edge a little bit because you've got a lead? And you do have to credit the other team some because they've made some adjustments to start to slow them down. Can they find those counters now? Those extra plays or plays they haven't run that'll be effective and get them back moving again?
They'll be looking for something or anything to seize that momentum back. They stay on the ground again. It's home. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. That'll settle back for the loss of three on the play.
This game, but really nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one. Maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
Kane Wilson. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Right there at the 43. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads him so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Here's Smith now on second down. As he slides to a stop. Call it a pickup of 7. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
Defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, they picked up a first down for him, too.
Smith's going to give this one. Short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive took a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settled things down a little bit. Place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, explosive plays, I'm talking the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive the team towards victory.
Only a yard on the pickup there, 2nd and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt, and so far today, he's got one, but it's denied as he tries to get the second.
Stops short of the goal line, down at the 2. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, but that'll make it 3rd and goal. So they need 2 yards here on 3rd down. Remember, they're already 2 of 2 on 3rd down conversion. They'll try to run the play, and not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. Now it appears we've got a Chief moving pretty gingerly down there. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough. Incomplete. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. That is an intriguing call. You got a chip shot field goal. Tight game. Why not just take the three?
I know that not all the rules apply in today's NFL. Send a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want.
Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Offense comes to the line now. First and 10.
Patriot!
On this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Gotta get a score.
And it's a good with a field goal, not necessarily need a touchdown. Now it's set up the screen. That's complete. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught.
Because
you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by him and setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one. Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's getting up and down. It's Gronkowski. And look at a big hook to the shoulder. What a decision to go for it on fourth from their own territory, and it pays off. 48 yards. It's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Call it a one-yard gain on the play. Second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Rush coming in, he's taken down. Derek Johnson leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. New England on third down, as bad as you can be. 0 for 7 thus far. This will be third and 15. They'll drop the throw.
Until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. If we put a good point on him, the defense is going to win more every now and then.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
On the ground. That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
The tight end Kelsey has it. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Come on.
kick by Butker is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So yet another field goal to end a drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit five of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call him your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
Now comes Brian Hoyer and the offense to take over. This is something we've seen many times over the course of his career. Can he pull off another fourth quarter comeback?
That's very strange, isn't it? Because when it's a play of this magnitude, even if the guys on defense are shot in the spot, they may be the most nervous people in the stadium because they've seen this happen to too many people before, too many teams. They've got to find a way to shut him down.
Midfield and inside the 45. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Back to throw. Goes inside the 40. And he's going to get this inside the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. They look to throw. Oh, a crusher here as it's intercepted.
Scouting points are earned every week. Make sure you use all of your points. A portion of your remaining points will be lost when you advance the week.
Oh.